pan out.
Oh, well, then he just stays here. I mean, we're back where we started. But if his information leads to something...
Arrests.
What?
If his information leads to arrests.
Well, yeah, well, if his information leads to arrests, then charges go away. Okay, now how can you say no to that? That is a win-win for you guys.
Give us one minute.
Good.
Okay, Domingo. Start talking.
Like I said, the dealers kick up the cash. I don't know who picks it up. All I know is that there are these three dead drops they run on Thursday night.
Hold on.
What?
Look, I know how this goes, all right? My guy talks to you, you squeeze him out like a sponge, then you dump him back on the street. Word gets out that he's a fink, he ends up bleeding out in front of his mother's house.
What?
It's not gonna happen, okay? Do you hear what I'm saying? My client is not leaving here with a target on his back.
Fine. We'll take care of him. Assuming this isn't one big jag-off, it looked like he got out because his lawyer's a genius.
Okay, and he's not just anyone's CI either, all right? You don't pass him around like a venereal disease. He's your personal CI. So he gets picked up, he calls me, I call you, gets taken care of, no questions asked.
Okay. But it's contingent.
Sure.
And this better be worth it.
Yeah. Okay. So, like I said, there are these three dead drops. First one's under a bridge up by Chavez Road, over Hillsdale Street. Second one's in an empty rail yard, off Waldron, in a train shed.